Hi friends, it's Rixana from Rixana's Home Interiors, and I had a little technical difficulty, so I'm back to finish my thought. I was at a client's house last week, and we are going to be working on a master suite, kind of a full gut renovation. We are gutting the bathroom, and we're going to revamp the master bedroom. And while I was there, my client said to me that as another phase down the line is she wanted to kind of revisit some of the styling and so forth for the rest of the house. And the house is absolutely lovely. And so I pressed her on that. I said, "What exactly are you looking to do?" And she paused and she said, "I need courage." And when she said that, I knew exactly what it is that she meant. Interior design is actually more complicated than people think, because to some extent there is a science to interior design, and it's thorough knowledge of the color wheel and of undertones. And there's even math involved, right? For those of us that say, "Oh, we hate math." And believe me, math was never my strong suit. But so this was about a month ago. I had a VIP style session with a client. And what a VIP style session is essentially a consultation on steroids. So it's a much longer consultation, it's very robust. And we do a little bit of follow-up in terms of documentation and providing them with checklists and tools for them to move forward. These particular clients have a very large master bedroom. And it's a two-story bedroom with like a cathedral ceiling and so forth. And the previous homeowners were obviously DIY homeowners, because this beautiful large master suite had incredibly standard, skimpy, off-the-rack trim molding. And there's actually a ratio of proper trim molding size and crown molding size based on the size of the wall and the volume of the room. And people don't know that. People think, well, it's a room, it needs trim molding and crown molding, so I'll put it up. But again, this gets back to the science of interior design. Something else that we study in school in terms of the scientific left brain side is balance and proportion and scale and even repetition. Those are all very, very important to get a room that feels right, that feels good. And I'm working with another client right now where we're doing design strategy. And design strategy is where we complete the design, we provide the measurements, we do the specifications and provide the fabrics, and then we hand the design off to the client for them to implement independently as their time and budget allow. And in this particular client's home, she has a very narrow living room. And my design concept was actually a very small scale, streamlined, kind of like a mid-century modern sectional with a chaise at one end. And her immediate reaction was, "It's big, and I think I need chairs." And I understand that fear, because part of it is just habit. We are used to having chairs, we're used to having things a certain way. And when you see something that isn't necessarily that, you don't have the confidence or the courage to move forward. And so I'm helping this client kind of work through the options. Of course, part of our design strategy always provides additional options, and we do make edits and so forth. And I'm hoping that she has the courage to just to move forward with the overall vision, because the room really will benefit from a smaller scale sectional as opposed to a series of pieces of furniture. If you have worked with me, you know that when we move from design strategy, which is the design's concept, into full service design, we have another junction where there is a new letter of agreement. And that letter of agreement is procurement and fulfillment and contract administration, which allows us to kind of move forward, purchase the items, get the contractors in, and start with the whole implementation. And in that letter of agreement, I actually have a passage that talks about the psychology of change. I have had in my 18 years of experience many panicked telephone calls to the firm for various reasons. I remember one off the top of my head. A client had never had window treatments, and we hung window treatments, and it was different. And of course, she was very happy, but at the moment, prior to everything else being installed and just going from no window treatments from 20 years to suddenly having window treatments, it did cause a little bit of anxiety. And that's why I put that disclaimer into my letter of agreement, because it's not abnormal for people to fear change and to be uncomfortable with change. And one of the ways that I combat this is to actually make a comprehensive presentation. I do this differently than other design firms in the sense that when we sit down for our broad brush preliminary presentation meeting, it is pretty comprehensive. And that actually allows my clients to see my vision and to see everything in its entirety. So it makes sense. There's always, we say, method to the madness, right? But there's always a reason we make selections. And design is definitely in the details. And everything from the contrast welt on a pillow to the nail head trim on a chair to a particular finish on a piece of furniture, all of those things combine create one cohesive, polished look. And that's ultimately what we're after. When you hire a designer, our job is to make your life easier. And of course, we give you confidence and courage to move forward to implement the plan. So I hope you enjoyed watching. And remember, with Rixana's Home Interiors, you will always have a well-designed day. Thanks so much, friends.